Hi guys, today I'm going to give you my first impressions on Inna Hugh's new tarot deck. Now this deck cannot be purchased from Amazon or anything like that, you have to go directly to Inna Hugh's website, which I will link in the description below. As I'm talking about this deck, I'll show you the cards to give you an idea of their style and feel. To me this deck has a very modern style, and one thing I love is how the people are represented within the cards. I'm going to put it out there, I can see this deck being compared to the Wild and Known Tarot. I actually use this as my main working deck at the moment. The modern style and the black and white and the use of colour is my main reason for saying that. However, for me, this is where the similarities end. There is just a whole different feel to this deck. Each card does have a very thin border, and I really like this. It helps to frame each card without being intrusive on the imagery. At the bottom of each card is the name, and for those who aren't fully au fait with the meanings yet, or don't read intuitively, they can move to the guidebook for a little help. This makes the deck great for beginners, as well as readers who are used to reading. Now another thing I really like about the deck is the fact that it came with a nice thick guidebook, rather than having to purchase it separately. Personally, I like to have guidebooks to get an insight of the author's meanings and symbolism. You don't actually have to use it, but it's just nice to look at different perspectives. I'll tell you something strange about myself. If I love something, like I really love it a huge amount, I have a tendency to go out and buy a second just to keep it sealed in case anything happens to it. I know it may seem like a waste of money, but I just panic at the thought of not having it if it gets lost or damaged. This is the first deck that I've ever had this feeling with. So to me this shows how much I love it already. These are only my first impressions, so I can't give you a full review. However, physically they are great quality. The cards are thick and sturdy, but not too thick. They also have a smooth half matte half glossy finish to them. The box is also great quality. It's the thick cardboard ones that people tend to like to keep. I'm going to stop here with the cards, because if you do go on to purchase this gorgeous deck, it's nice to have some surprises. However, for those who would like to see every card, I'm going to add some images at the end of this video. So, now on to the book. The book has 187 pages, so it's quite meaty, and each card has one page for a black and white image, and the second page for a description. At the start of the book, you have a few pages about the deck, the suits, and some spreads. It then goes on to the card meanings. Each description also has some shadow information, which is great if you'd like to do some shadow work with this deck. And finally, at the back you have some information and photos about the deck creators. Now I know that Inna Hugh also has a beautiful oracle deck. I don't actually own this, however I know it's very popular, especially within the Instagram community, and I can see this deck having the same response. So, to wrap it up, if you can't already tell, I'm totally in love with this deck and I can't wait to work with it. I'm going to add some images now of the full deck, so if you'd like to keep it more of a mystery, I would say to stop watching in a couple of seconds. But thank you to you all. If you have enjoyed watching, please be sure to like and subscribe for more deck reviews and collections. If you have any questions, just write them below and I'll do my best to try and answer them.